Hi all, welcome to the next session on commodity derivatives and risk management, and we will be discussing different aspect of electricity, spot and derivatives trading. And one thing I would like to say at this point of time is that in India, derivatives trading in electricity is not permitted as per the CERC, that is Central Electricity Regulatory Commission, which is the regulatory body for all activities pertaining to the electricity generation, distribution, retailing, etc. However, we will be discussing very briefly about some of the derivative contracts which are listed in other derivative exchanges globally. Now let's understand how exactly spot price of electricity is arrived at. If you recall, in all commodities, that is has been our focus on understanding how spot price is arrived. Who are the players, who are the consumers, producers, and what are the supply demand factors which influences the spot price. So let's understand little bit on how spot prices arrived at in the electricity market. And as I all of you know, this spot market is the wholesale trading of electricity leading to physical delivery. So in case of a spot transactions, buyer and seller arrive at a price and which leads to delivery of electricity. And in case of a derivatives trading, which is not happening in India, even globally in whichever exchange electricity derivative contracts are traded, does not lead to delivery. These are financially or cash settled. At the end of the contract maturity day, buyer and seller pay money to each other based on whatever the price difference, and the contract comes to an end. And which are important power exchanges. So you may have heard an organization called Nord Pool. Nord Pool is the Nordic power exchange, which covers the Norway, Denmark, Sweden and Finland market, and it is now known as Nasdaq Commodities Europe. And in this particular exchange, you have different derivative contracts pertaining to electricity gets traded. Another exchange is APX Index, is the European Energy Exchange, which is operating primarily at Netherlands, United Kingdom and Belgium. You have PowerNext and EEX. These two exchanges are for spot trading of electricity leading to delivery of electricity. They don't have derivative contracts traded. So you have these two exchanges ensure that the electricity gets delivered in Germany, France, Austria and Switzerland. And you have two other electricity exchanges, that is your PGM Interconnections and California ISO. They are wholesale market, that is wholesale market leading to delivery of electricity, while the Chicago Mercantile Exchange is the exchange where you have financial derivative contracts on electricity trade. And in India, we have two exchanges. This is your India Energy Exchange and Power Exchange India Limited. And these exchanges are used for spot trading of electricity. Now let's go to understanding little bit on global electricity market. And if you can see, this one mostly non-renewable energy sources is predominantly used for electricity generation, though renewable energy sources such as solar, wind and water is increasingly getting used to generate electricity. However, coal-based electricity generation or thermal power generation remains the maximum or has the maximum share in electricity generation, or coal has the maximum share in electricity generation. So you have, if you see, South Africa has 93% of the total electricity which is generated is based on coal, so and so forth. Germany has the lowest, which has got around 46% of the total electricity generated is based on coal. And just quickly take you through, all of you may be knowing what are the different dimension of electricity business. So you have generation, so electricity power generators or gencos we call them. So you have renewable, they can use renewable sources or non-renewable sources. Besides generation, you have transmission, so long distance transmission, interstate and inter-region transmission is another set of activity. Distribution, from these transmission lines to actually delivering electricity to consumers, household and industries, this is done through distribution companies. And you have your retailing is another set of activities which is deals with arrangement for meter reading, billing, collection of electricity charges, online support, etc. And I'm not going into detail of electricity generation using your power, using your coal. So this particular picture I have taken from the World Coal Association, which very clearly explains how the powdered coal is used to generate electricity. So if you are interested more on, you know, how exactly it is done, so you can visit this World Coal Association website and get to know more about the whole process of electricity generation from coal. Now let's go to quickly understand electricity market in India. So electricity is in concurrent list, so electricity production, distribution, etc., transmission, distribution, production, retailing, everything is under your central government as well as state government, and some private sector entities also operate. So who are the major public sector bodies? You have NTPC, National Thermal Power Company, which is interested with the generating electricity. You have Power Grid Corporation of India, which is responsible for interstate transmission of electricity, transmission and distribution of electricity. You have Power Trading Corporation of India for power trading. So these three bodies are under public sector, under central government. And each state has its own state electricity boards, and there is an emergence of many, public sector, private sector companies which are, in the business of generation, transmission, distribution, and power trading. So you have Tata Power, GBK, Reliance Power, SR Power, Torrent Power, Suzlon Energy, etc. Many companies from India which are involved in generation, distribution and retailing as well as transmission of electricity. And Electricity Act of 2003 governs all regulatory aspects of electricity in India. And Central Electricity Authority and Regulatory Commission, that is your CERC, is the sole regulator of electricity market. And in this context, I would like to discuss a little bit about Power Grid Corporation of India's responsibility. So what exactly Power Grid Corporation of India undertakes is that it creates the necessary infrastructure for interstate and inter-regional electric power transmission system. So all of us, you must have seen when we, travel by train or something, we get to see these high voltage, transmission lines. So Power Grid Corporation of India is responsible for creation and maintaining of those those grid lines. And Power Grid Corporation of India also, through its one of the joint one of its subsidiary has three centers. That is your national load dispatch center, regional load dispatch center, and state load dispatch center. And these three centers work in jointly so that seamless transmission and distribution of electricity happens. So the main responsibility of these load dispatch centers is to ensure that unnecessary load is not there in the transmission line. So they balances the load throughout the grid. And CERC has the power to penalize buyers and sellers, and it tries to bring in a disciplined behavior for smooth functioning of the grid. And for that, CERC has a guideline called, or CERC has a regulation called Unscheduled Interchange Charges and Related Matters Regulation 2009. So this unscheduled interchange happens when a electricity generator generates lower volume of electricity than it agreed for, or buyers withdraw more amount of electricity or higher amount of electricity that it demanded during a given period of time. So this behavior is penalized by CERC. If you recall, one such event happened during 30th and 31st July 2012, when most part of northern India, western India, and eastern India were on blackout because of the grid failure. So the NLDC, SLDC, and RLDC jointly work together so that the efficiency of the grid and load bearing capacity of the grid is maintained. Now let's quickly go to the electricity market in India. Normally, whenever a company is generating electricity, it enters into a long-term power purchase agreement with some other companies, by which this generation company will be able to sell electricity to that company or those companies for a considerable period of time, and this long-term power purchase agreement can run into more than seven years. So the base load, which is produced by the electricity generation company, that is normally sold as part of the long-term power purchase agreement, and any residual generation they enter into short-term bilateral contracts. And any other residual electricity which they have, that comes to the exchange platform for trading. So when we are talking about IEX and Power Exchange India Limited, we are talking about this day ahead market, in which the companies which have some surplus electricity, they bring it to the exchange platform so that buyers and sellers demand is met and price is arrived at. So if you see the daily variation, let me repeat, buyers enter into long-term power purchase agreement with the sellers for their regular base load requirement. Seasonal variation in electricity demand is managed through short-term bilateral contract, and daily variation is managed through day-ahead power exchanges, where this IEX and PXIL come into picture. So let's go to what happens at IEX or PXIL. We'll discuss in detail. So India has got two energy exchange: this Power Exchange India Limited and India Energy Exchange. So you have, as part of this exchange, you have spot trading of electricity. So when we are talking about spot trading of electricity, we mean that the price the buyers and sellers give their bid today. Based on the bid, the order matching happens, and all this happens on T minus 1 day. So the buyers and sellers negotiate the price at the exchange platform on T minus 1 day, and electricity is delivered on the next day. And a buyer or seller can enter into buy or sell bid for 15 minutes blocks per day. So that means a day is divided into 96 blocks, and based on the demand and supply bidding, the price at which buyers are bidding, the bid volume, bid price, sell volume and sell price determines what helps an exchange to determine what is called a market clearing price or a system price. And the volume which gets cleared is known as your unconstrained market volume, so or MCV. Now let's go to take an example. How? Okay, before I go, I'll just take you to I hope you are able to see this detail. Yes, if you this is the detail which I have downloaded for from India Energy Exchange for today. This is the 28th June 2016. This is the price which is prevailing at India Energy Exchange. So let me even make little bigger. So if you see, between 00 to 15 hours, that is 12 o'clock, sorry, 12 to 12:15 in the night. So buyers and sellers have agreed to buy and sell electricity at a price of 2,300.34 per megawatt hour. And these are India is also divided into 12 regions, so A1, A2, E1, E2, N1, N2, so on and so forth. Now let's take an example. How we'll take a real life example to understand how this price is arrived. If you see this rightmost column shows the word MCP, that is your market clearing price or system price. Let's make a note of it, that is your 2,300.34. And in fact, if you see, the whole of the first row is also 2,334. So let's come to let's take example how exactly this 2,334 has been arrived open. Now, typical, in your macroeconomics, you must have seen a classical picture of demand supply and demand supply interacting with each other. And most of the textbook will say that when the demand and supply, the intersection point tells us what is the equilibrium price and equilibrium volume. Exactly the same concept is applied here. Now, let's take this example. So you have, let's say, on day T minus 1, that is, suppose yesterday T minus 1, T minus Yes. So in the T minus 1, you have, let's say, different buyers are bidding and different sellers are bidding. So the buyers don't know what sellers are doing, and sellers don't know what the buyers are doing, but they are interested to buy and sell electricity for 15-minute block, let's say starting at 10 a.m. in the morning to 10:15 a.m. So a buyer is interested to take electricity from the grid, and similarly, seller wants to inject the electricity into the grid during this 10 to 10:15 hours. And at what price they will be buying or selling, and they come to the exchange platform for arriving this particular price. And on day T minus 1, they will be giving different bids. Let's take this example of different bids. Let's say this is your randomly these beats are coming for this particular time lot. 3000 by volume quantity, 3000 units comes at a 2.5 rupees, that is your kilowatt hour price. So some company is interested to buy 3000 kilowatt hour at a price per price of 2005 rupees per kilowatt hour. So you will have similarly different, if you see the lowest price is 2.5 and highest price is 4. So this is, sorry, the lowest price is 2.25 and the highest price is 4 rupees per kilowatt hour, and different corresponding different quotations have come. Similarly, on T-1 different sellers are also quoting different price. So you have, if you see, you have the highest sell price, that is the sell price 4.5 rupees per kilowatt hour was bidded by a party who is interested to sell 2000 units of electricity, 2000 kilowatt hour of electricity at this time period. Now the question is, how do we arrive at the equilibrium or the interaction between supply and demand? It's a very simple exercise. Let's start with I hope you are able to see this. Okay, let me ask this question to you. Let's see if the buy price. So if you have, we have to calculate something called cumulative buy. So cumulative buy, that's quantity and price. So let me ask you a question. If how many units are desired at a price of 4.5, how many units of electricity has been desired to be bought at a price of 4.50? No. So you have on 4.5, it is 0. Now let's go to 4. In a 4, or no, we have 4.25. So at 4.25, how many units are desired? We have 1600 units are desired. So in 4.25 we have 1600 units. Now let's go to 4. So how many cumulative units will be desired? If somebody is interested to buy electricity at 4.5 or 4.25, he will also be very happy to buy electricity at 4. So what will be the cumulative buy volume at a price of 4? So it is going to be 1600 plus this 900. If you see this, this is corresponds to the 4. So it you will have 2500. Similarly, let's go to the sale. So you have a cumulative sale. If you have a cumulative sale contract, so you have a quantity and price. Let's start with the lowest price. Suppose a price of lowest price is 2.25. In the whole system, the lowest price is 2.25. So at 2.25, please tell me how many units of electricity has been indicated to be delivered. If you see, 2.25 does not feature, so you have a quantity delivered is 0. Now let's go to 2.5. So how many units has been interested to be delivered? So you have a 800. So you obviously, the person who is interested to sell at 2.25, you will be very happy to sell at 2.5, but because the quantity is 0, so cumulative value is 800 here. Now let's go to the next price, 2.75. Is there somebody interested to deliver? Yes, this is 2000. So how much is going to be the total cumulative deal? Cumulative amount is going to be 2800. So at a price of 2.75, how many total amount is willing to be delivered is 2800. So I have prepared, let's go to the just give me a minute please. Okay, yes, so if you see this, if you can see this particular, this is what I discussed. This is your buy quantity and buy price, sell quantity and sell price, and this is your cumulative detail buy quantity. If you recall, this at a 4.5 as a buy price, nobody was interested for nobody was interested to buy any electricity. 4.25 it is 1600, 4 it is 2500, so on and so forth. Similarly, at 2.25 nobody was interested to sell electricity, and 2.5 800 units were willing to be sold at 2.5, so on and so forth, and at a 4.5 you have 8000 units were available to be sold. Now you have a classical supply demand curve. So this is what exactly the supply demand curve looks like. In textbook this diagram is very smooth, but in real life this is with this kind of a discrete data point, the supply demand curve looks like in this manner. So if you see this one, the x axis has price and y axis has quantity. So let me repeat here, x axis has price and y axis has quantity. So this you have to be a little sense, you have to remember that this particular diagram has price in the x axis and quantity in the y axis. So, and this is your cumulative sell curve. As the price increases, more volume are available to be sold, and as the price decreases, less amount are interested to be bought. So this is what your supply demand curve. And if you see this one, now how do we find out this interaction point? So this interaction point is, if you see 1 2 3 4, between 4 and 5 of the cumulative sell points, and this is again 4 and 5 of cumulative buy points. So we have to use some mechanism to find out exactly how what is going to be the interaction point. Let's quickly take how this has been done. If you see this, I have already if you see this one, this is your demand curve, this is your supply curve, but we are only taking, this is your 3 and this is your 4th and 5th point in that previous graph. This is 4th, 5th point, this is your 4th and 5th point. Now how do we find out the x and y? And we know this is, you have price in this axis, you have quantity in this axis. Now what are the coordinate of this particular point? This is 3 and 4000. Coordinate of this point is 3.25 and 3400. Coordinate of this point is 3000 and 2800, and coordinate of this point is xy value is 3.25 to 3000 3800. Now, using your interpolation formula, we'll be able to find out. This is your simple interpolation formula. We want to find out what is going to be the value of x and y. So, using the this is the interpolation formula. I'm sure all of you must be knowing. So, when you solve these two equations, y1 and 2, what we will get is the market clearing price or market clearing volume. So, whatever the x coordinate we'll get for this, and the y coordinate is going to be market clearing price and market clearing volume. Now, let's see. This is again manually drawn, so it looks kind of a smooth. This is the total graph, and this is your points 3 and 3.25. this is your 3 and 3.25, the x coordinate of the four identified points. Let's say when we use the formula, we find out what is the market clearing price or the equilibrium price is 3.20. that means any buyer who has quoted more than 3.20, he will be able to buy electricity, and any seller who has quoted a price less than 3.20 will be able to sell electricity. Now let's focus on to this particular graph. So any seller who is here in this range, whose bid is in this range, that seller will be able to deliver. And a buyer who is in this range, means a buyer who has bidded a price more than 3.20, he will be able to get the electricity, he will be able to buy electricity. And a seller who has bidded less than 3.20 will be able to sell the electricity. So this is how the exchange is going to calculate the market clearing price and market clearing volume for every 15 minutes. So on a given day, depending upon the buy sell order, you will have 96 market clearing price and 96 market clearing volume for a specific day. Now, we will be continuing with our discussion on the remaining part of electricity contract and electricity spot trading and futures trading in the next session. And as usual, I'm going to end up this session by saying that looking forward to interacting with you all in the next session. Thank you, all of you.